It's the news no mother wants to hear. Your child has been diagnosed with stage 4 cancer. This became Sharifa Francis's reality at her daughter's 6-week clinic checkup.
Only thing we know, you get cancer, you die. You get the treatment, you're gonna die. So that was basically, so you can imagine just getting up every day and just knowing that, okay, any day could be her last because it was stage 4. We all know what stage 4 means. And so every day, the first thing you do when you get up is to check if she's alive.
And at just 3 months old, doctors recommended chemotherapy for baby Cassidy.
I didn't want to do it because, to be honest, I did not know anything positive about chemo. Like, the stories that I heard was nothing normal. But then if I made the decision not to do whatever on anything, because I knew something was going to happen to her at that time, I was sure. So I know that when it happened, everybody's going to say it's my fault. And so even though I know it was painful and it's going to be bad for her, I still had to make the decision to let her do it so that, you know, because that's the safe way. So that's how I made the decision. So I wasn't planning on stopping the chemo or anything, but it just happened in such a way where I had no choice.
After doing one round of chemo with no improvement, a stronger dose was recommended. But the 27-year-old mother could not bear the sight of her child in pain, so she contacted a doctor who suggested changing her diet to all natural foods.
Yeah, we started this diet on May 28th, and on July 12th, I could send my sister pictures showing improvement, like her tummy was getting softer and smaller, and so that means the tumor was shrinking and the kidney and the liver was shrinking.
3 years later, baby Cassidy is healthier than ever.
She have never even, to be honest, so far she have never even had a common flu. Like, she's as healthy as possible. As it relates to the cancer, there's no tumor and her liver is normal size.
So she's encouraging parents not to give up on their sick children.
For all people with ailing children, it's never too late. There's a way. All hope is not gone. It pays to think positive, and for this we have to have positive people around us. And sometimes we have to cut back on all the people that are not on our journey, that doesn't fit on our journey. We have to know how to let them go and just move on.
With your ray of hope, I'm Cody Ann Barrett.